I just drove cross country from Massachusetts to Arizona, and I thought it might be fun and interesting to talk about how much a trip like that costs in a little diesel short bus like Max. The answer is too much. It costs too much. That's how much. But if you want the details, stick around.
Maximalist minibus with Mary and Captain and you. Get on the bus!
I am sitting here in my beautiful sister's beautiful backyard in beautiful Maricopa, Arizona. If you're wondering why I'm here and what's going on with Kat and Captain and all that stuff, I'm going to be posting an update really soon. But for now, we're going to dig into something else. Driving across America in a little bus. This was actually my 8th time doing it in one direction or the other. I'm not claiming that I have figured out how to do things the best way or the cheapest way or even the most fun way, but I have done it 8 times, so that should count for something. I'm going to go over this last trip and talk about how much it costs right now. I use Mint to track my expenses across multiple accounts. I'm not an affiliate. I just use it. It's not perfect, but it's free, although I like the web version much better than the phone app. I also use spreadsheets. I use Numbers for Mac, but Google Sheets, Excel, anything will work. You should probably set up a spreadsheet of your own. So let's look at what I spent. The biggest expense, as you can imagine, was fuel. Max is a diesel, and he's not the most aerodynamic vehicle you're ever going to find, which means that the miles per gallon vary widely, depending on conditions like wind, terrain, all that stuff. But the most significant factor in Max's miles per gallon is speed. Traveling at a constant speed of about 55 miles an hour gets the best results, but really any constant speed is going to be way better than any kind of stop and go. I use an app called Road Trip, not to be confused with another app I told you about called Road Trippers. This one, Road Trip, is for tracking fuel. And according to the app, on this trip, my highest miles per gallon was a whopping 18.81 miles per gallon. And that was on a day where most of the driving was 55 miles an hour on a small 2-lane highway with long, fairly gentle downhill stretches and a good tailwind. The lowest, the worst, was a terrible 8.83 miles per gallon in basically the opposite conditions, you know, traveling faster, probably 75 miles an hour, and fighting a side wind. My average was 12.35. I mean, it's a bus, you know, it's not going to get great mileage. According to Mint, I spent $1,344.94 on fuel. On average, fuel is $5 a gallon. I didn't really track the specifics of that so well, but it was more in some places, less in others. So yeah, I'm going to estimate $5 a gallon. So that's about 269 gallons. Multiply that times 12.35, which is my average miles per gallon, and that comes to 3,174 miles. So that's about right for the trip. The next biggest expense is food. I'm not counting regular groceries, dog food, things like that, because that's stuff that doesn't have anything to do with driving cross country. It's money I would have spent whether I was stationary or moving. But when I'm in active travel mode, I do a lot more eating out. If I'd been traveling a little slower, spending more time at each stop, I would have cooked and eaten the way I usually do, you know, even though I'm traveling. But I had a deadline. I was moving quickly. And that means a lot more road food, which is fast food. Some of the highly nutritious places that I ate while driving cross country, Dunkin' Donuts, Arby's, Taco Bell, McDonald's, Del Taco, Panera Bread, KFC, Carl's Jr., Five Guys, and then a lot of random gas station food and drinks. Overall on this trip, I spent $265 on food, and that is 18 days, $14.72 a day. That's more than I spend when I'm cooking, but it could be a lot worse. I'm just one person, of course, and one dog. If you're a family traveling, it's obviously going to cost you a lot more to do road food along the way. Next, entertainment. I really only did one thing that I would put in that category, but it was expensive. I went to Cedar Point Amusement Park in Sandusky because it's famous for having some amazing roller coasters. Parking there is $30. My admission ticket with a web discount was $71.78, so that's $101.88 for, what, 4 hours of fun? I mean, I could have spent a lot more in entertainment, but there just really wasn't time to do much else that I would put in that category. Lodgings were very cheap. I only paid for 2 overnight spots the whole way across the country. And you might think that's because I was doing truck stops or Walmarts or something, but I actually did surprisingly little of that. We did get a couple of free rides at places that are normally paid, like Uncle B's Hip Camp in South Dakota, and a campground in Durango, Colorado, where a friend of mine is the camp host. I did also spend one night in Mike's driveway in Wisconsin. Thanks, Mike. But mostly I stayed at very cool free places. The majority of those came from freecampsites.net, and the 2 that I paid for also came from free campsites. The paid places were Creek Park in Dodge Center, Minnesota, with a suggested donation of $10, and the Rock County Fairgrounds in Bassett, Nebraska. Again, suggested donation $10. So $20 is all I spent on accommodation. At the fairgrounds, the $10 even includes hookups. There's electricity on every telephone pole. I had my navigation apps set to avoid tolls the whole time, so only once did I actually pay a fee to travel. And that's when I took the ferry across Lake Champlain from Charlotte, Vermont to Essex, New York. The cost of that was $16.50. It's $11.75 for vehicles up to 19 feet, but max is 20 feet, so $16.75. Still a bargain, I would say. Okay, I'm going to include one more thing, even though it's technically something I'd be paying for even if I didn't travel cross country, and that is, when I arrived in Arizona, I had an oil change at Valvoline. With a diesel, you typically only need to change your oil about every 5,000 miles, but on a long trip like this, with so much driving every day, I generally do an oil change at the start and another one at the end. So that was $200, including a couple of extra things I had them do. But to me, it's worth it for the peace of mind. When I left Massachusetts, I budgeted a total of $1,800 for the trip. I didn't factor in the oil change or the roller coasters, and I spent a little more on food than I expected, but I was actually under on fuel. The total spent for the drive across America was $1,948.47. Not too far over. Definitely not cheap. And remember, that is only one way. I probably spent about the same thing getting to Massachusetts, though I don't have an official rundown to share with you on that. If you are currently on the East Coast and you plan to come out to Quartzsite or wherever for the winter, make sure you do your own calculations based on real information about your own vehicle. If you don't normally track your miles per gallon, start now before the big trip so there's not going to be any surprises. You'll be glad you did. If you're in a van or you're in a car or if it's a gas vehicle, I'm sure you're going to do better than I did. You have to factor in your own comfort level too and plan on a couple of motel stays or hookups if you need them. If you do groceries instead of road food, you could save some money there. And of course, you could skip the roller coasters, but no, don't skip the roller coasters or, you know, or whatever your version of the roller coasters might be, because you only live once. And you only drive cross country, what, maybe 8 times? Of course, there's also wear and tear on the bus to worry about. Though Max did absolutely great all the way across the country and waited until I got to Arizona to have problems. And I will have a video about those problems. But anyway, they're dealt with now. I've got Max back. Now my focus is on Kat. She's got some big medical hurdles coming up. So keep her in your mind, in your thoughts, and check out the GoFundMe link below. But meanwhile, if you got something out of this video, even if all you got was a good laugh at the crazy lady driving the bus, please subscribe and watch some more crazy lady bus videos and learn from my mistakes, because that is why I make them. Get off!